Delighted to say Will Lyons is still with us. He's about to open a bottle of fizz. But first, well, I think first it's time to put Meghan Watsit in the therapist chair. And Honey Lancaster-James, our therapist, is here to do the business. Kevin, lead us into this, please.
Yeah, according to those much-quoted palace insiders...
Someone's had too much wine.
I'll start again. According to those much-quoted palace insiders, Meghan Markle is such a fervent social mountaineer...
Meghan Windsor.
Whatever. Her nickname in high places is Meghan Megane, yes. With her oh-so-fashionable PC statements about feminism and her theatrical approval of her husband Harry's notorious woke speech, in which he hailed today's young people as the best generation ever in the history of humanity. Is the so-called Duchess of Sussex a pushy American on the make? Is she an actress delivering the poor performance of her life to get to the top? Has Kate Middleton rumbled her? Or is she a much-maligned, decent woman suffering the slings and arrows of a British press which loves to build them up just to knock them down. Over to you, honey.
Where do we start, honey?
Well, thanks for giving me two glasses of wine before I had to put Meghan Markle in the chair.
I think that's number three, technically.
Well, I've got to say, I actually, regardless of whether you like Meghan Markle or not, I feel sorry for her. You know, it's hard enough when you marry into a completely different kind of family to yours, or you come from different cultural backgrounds. But to do that on the international stage, that has got to be hugely, hugely stressful. And then, of course, she's constantly getting compared to Kate Middleton, who everybody has already sort of taken to their heart.
Just roll back a bit, because I'm with you.
Yeah.
And I also think, whatever people might think about Meghan, she's obviously a very bright and talented woman.
Mm-hmm.
And people say you can't help who you fall in love with. Although I often wonder, if I was to meet the female equivalent of Tommy Robinson and I would be a single man, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be able to fall in love with Tanya Robinson, because I think they're probably a horrible, hideous racist, and it wouldn't work well. So
Where are we going with this?
Well, what I'm saying is you can help who you fall in love with.
Okay.
And actually, so when we start off saying, oh, I feel a little sorry for her, she's made choices.
Yeah.
Choices that elevate her from a high-profile actress and a darling of the Hollywood set to becoming an international figure, but also critically within the royal family,
mm-hmm.
an international figure where you're not really allowed to say or do anything, because that's how our royal family works.
Well, I think that's the inherent sort of irony for her, because, you know, we know from her background before she married into the royal family that she was already very keen on
sharing her voice
and lending her support to various campaigns. So I think it would be very unfair of us to say that she's just using this post just because of that. It's clearly who she is. It's clearly what she's been doing since she was a very young girl. But that is a conflict, because now she's in a position where, on the one hand, she's got this international platform, but on the other hand, she's very much tied by what she's allowed to speak and what she's allowed to say and do in public.
I don't know if you've seen Dickie Arbiter is in the papers today, and he's the former press aide to Buckhouse. And tabloidese here, but I mean, he's basically saying she should shut up.
I mean, one of the things that unfortunately that goes with being part of the royal family is that actually everybody wants them to sort of turn up, shake hands, smile sweetly, and actually say very little.
Which is what Kate and William do.
Yes, yeah. Because one of the reasons that, you know, people who support the royal family, what they like about the royals is that they unite people, and that everybody, regardless of their political interests, their
views. I'm a Republican.
Well, that's fine. But when they turn up, what they aim to do is to get the whole crowd sort of feeling positive. So, of course, if people come out from the royal family and start sharing their views, they're going to rub some people up the wrong way, for as many people are going to support them.
How, just because I think this is a really interesting point, how does she move on when she's already, I mean, you can see there's a degree of outspokenness, but the outspokenness comes at a price. You say something, you get criticised. They say to these young people, you're the most woke generation ever. Kevin tells me Prince Harry is a friend of the Dorchester Hotel, whose owner, of course, has just decided that he's going to start killing homosexuals from next Wednesday. You know, that's not very woke. So because of their unique position, if they speak out, they get criticised.
Yes.
And that criticism They don't like it in Buckingham Palace.
Well, I mean, I don't think anybody likes it, really, who's in a public position. It's very difficult for anybody nowadays, with social media being what it is, with the media being what it is. No matter what you say, there, for as many people who are going to agree with you and think you're great, there are going to be a whole other load of people queuing up just to tear strips off you and to sort of, you know, vent their anger at you. And that's a very difficult place to be, I think, in the modern world.
So how does she play it from now on? Does she listen to Dickie Arbiter, who has got 30, 40 years of experience, and shut up?
Mm.
Or does she follow her heart, and it seems that Harry is being very supportive, and carry on talking?
Well, it depends whether you want to look at this from the point of view of what's best for Meghan or what's best for the royal family. If you're thinking about what's best for her as a person, then I would always advocate, you know, do you.
Yep.
You know, you do your authentic self. If what you're doing is, you know, if you're using your platform to support things that you believe in, go for it. You know, that's what you want to do. If it's about being careful with the kind of royal family as an institution,
yes,
and not going down the route perhaps of previous royals who have sort of dissented from that and then ended up paying the price for that, then I think we have to sort of probably, she does need to take some advice. I mean, that advice is going to be there in place not only to protect the family or the firm, I think, as they call it,
yeah,
but also her as well.
Can you imagine her, Kevin, rowing back and actually minding what she says? Because I think that would really, she would find that very difficult.
I can't, and I'm just wondering what Honey thinks about not only Meg, psychologically, not only Meghan, but her coming together with Harry,
yeah,
and them as a duo.
Yeah.
They strike me,
yeah,
as a tour de force, a kind of double act.
They do, but I actually, the honest truth is, I don't actually think their relationship bodes that well for the future. If I was a betting person,
I'm with you, honey.
the reason for that is because what we know, sort of in terms of all the psychological research in attachment and relationships, is that the more similar your background is, the more chances you are of having a long-lasting relationship. But also, you know, your values. Now, they clearly do have some very similar values, but they couldn't come from more different backgrounds.
No, they couldn't.
And that is going to cause difficulty.
It's interesting because it's not very often that royal families get their hands dirty, so to speak, with romantic, especially premium premier roles.
Yeah.
Royals get their hands dirty with commoners.
But I think the other thing is the way they interact with one another. They seem to rescue each other quite a lot. And we were talking about this earlier, and that's never really a good place to be in a relationship.
Okay. Honey, you've worked hard for your money today.
Ah, thank
and
you.
In fact, we're going to be rewarded by Will Lyons here with a sparkling concoction.
Oh.
And a dark hue as well for a white. Is this a champagne or is that for us to guess?